become liable if you are negligent, if your business is negligent. So understand that as well. Two things on employment. This is kind of tying in contracts a little bit too. Florida is what is known as an at-will employment state. What does that mean? In Florida, an employer can fire, terminate an employee for any reason or no reason, so long as the basis for termination is not for a discriminatory purpose. Okay? In other words, as long as they are not terminating because on the basis of race, gender, and age, those are the big three, thank you, race, gender, and age, then an employer can fire an employee basically for any reason, okay? This is why employers, generally speaking, take a lot of precautions to document reasons for termination, and if they're smart, take disciplinary action leading up to a termination to document a pattern of employee behavior. Okay, that's why this is so important for businesses to be aware of. If, for example, an employee is perpetually late, okay, if that's documented, okay, or if there's performance reviews that show the goals weren't being met, performance as expected wasn't being performed, that way the employer can show, hey, there was this pattern of activity, this is the reason why we are terminating this employee for this failure to perform their duties as required, failure to get to work on time, whatever, not because she's a 65-year-old female. Right. Okay, an age and gender issue. All right, so in the future, there may be other protected classes.
Unless that's in their contract.
Well,
there's certain things that when you hit a certain age, you're forced to retire.
That then would be a contractual basis for unemployment, which is different than at will. So, if an employee is hired and they have an employment contract, that kind of gets you into a completely different realm, right? Because in that scenario, if an employee is under contract, they're technically only under contract for the period of the contractual term, right? You're a contract employee for a year, for 2 years, for 3 years, whatever. And there might be bases for termination of the contract and that employment contract as well, for failure to do any number of different things, okay? Outside of employees who are contractual employees, the at-will employment standards in Florida will apply, okay? Also on that, what I was going to say also, in the future, like I said, race, age, and gender are the big three protected classes. In the future, you know, we might see that expanded to things such as, I do wonder to what extent sexual orientation might come into play. In the future, there may be additional classes to which that receive those levels of employment protection. But right now, the short answer is race, gender, and age are the big three protected. Did you have a question?
Well, there is a county ordinance that protects the sexual preference.
Yeah. And that is a perfect example of an expansion of rights, okay? Mm-hmm. Like what we talked about, I think, in one of our first classes. Mm-hmm. The county has chosen to expand the rights that an employee has beyond just race, age, and gender to sexual orientation. So that's a perfect example of that expansion of rights. All right. Last thing is covenants not to compete in the employment context. This is, again, kind of tying together contracts a little bit. In Florida, non-compete agreements are enforceable. They are allowed. What is a non-compete agreement? A non-compete agreement is when an employer requires an employee to sign a document, to sign a contract that says, if the employee leaves, the employer quits, they will not go work for a competing employer for a certain period of time and within a certain geographic distance. The geographic distance and the amount of time and whether or not that is reasonable will vary wildly depending upon what kind of industry we're talking about, what type of profession it is. You know, if it's something very, very, very specialized that only a few people do, a very highly specialized skill, the court might find that, you know, there's only a few competitors, and so there may be a pretty broad geographic range of protecting you from engaging in working for a competing employer. Again, I don't even like giving examples because it can vary wildly, again, depending upon the nature of the profession and the nature of the business. But there can indeed be, so they are enforceable only as long as they're not overly restrictive. I cannot envision the courts enforcing a covenant not to compete, a non-compete agreement that said that somebody couldn't work for a competitor for 15 years, or anywhere in the geographic United States or something. Yeah. Those would, I think, just be very, very, that would be overly restrictive. But they certainly could say, you can't work for a year for a competitor. You can't work within a 50-mile radius of a competitor or something like that. But anyway, all right, I'm done. Are you sick of me yet? Sick of hearing me talk?
It's not like it was every week. So.
Yeah. If it had been every week, that would have been a different scenario. Well, thank you all for a great class. I really appreciate everybody being here that was able to be here. If you have any other questions, please let me know. And good luck on the final next Wednesday. All right. Yeah, make sure everybody signed in.